Korea and the United States are teaming up to study air quality on the Korean peninsula. The first phase of the multi-million dollar project has just come to an end, and the findings are already providing researchers with an insight into the root of the problem. The first of our three-part feature report, Air Quality in Focus, our Shin Se-min reports.
It's an aircraft packed with scientific equipment, and more specifically, the complex tools needed to study air quality over Korea. They call it a laboratory in the sky, as this 50-year-old jet has been completely redesigned and refitted with filters sticking out of its windows and air tubes spread around to collect air samples from ground level and up above in the air. Called the Korea-U.S. Air Quality Study, or KORUS-AQ, the joint research is the first time NASA has teamed up with an international partner, this time Korea's National Institute of Environmental Research. And together, the team is conducting a collaborative study by tying together aircraft, satellite, and ground-based measurements to measure air quality on the Korean peninsula.
This DC-8 turned into flying laboratory has taken a total of 20 flights over Korea in the past 6 weeks. That's much more than initially scheduled, as the air quality system has been much worse than expected.
Korea ranked a lowly 173rd out of 180 countries in terms of air quality on this year's Environmental Performance Index by Yale University, a result caused by decades of rapid industrial development and polluting power plants.
When we were coming down to land, what we assumed was the end of our flight, they actually couldn't see the runway well enough. And so they veered off at the last moment, and is just a sign of how turbid and how hazy the atmosphere was at that time.
Korea has long accused China for much of the air pollution in the country, saying yellow dust blowing in from the deserts of Mongolia and northern China has caused such hazy and congested skies. But the scientists crisscrossing the skies over the Korean peninsula say that's not strictly the case.
We have seen a lot of pollution coming from local sources, petrochemical plants, coal plants, and we've also done a lot of flights where we've tried to look at the external influences coming from the Yellow Sea, and so we're still looking into those data, but we have found that on a lot of days where we've had stagnant air, we have seen a lot of emissions from Korea itself.
Researchers say that with the current level of air pollution, there's no doubt it's very detrimental to the health of the Korean people. But one thing is for sure, this study shows the Korean government realizes the severity of the problem and, unlike many in the region, is at least seeking ways to help the nation breathe a little easier. Shin Se-min, Arirang News, Osan.